Oh, what's going on, guys? We are back with some more End of the Show 22 Franchise Mode, and on our team only has one player. Our team only has one target on our mind. I have one major target on my mind, and that is the Orioles' DJ Hall. It'll give us a nice lefty to add. And also, they have like a lot of control over Woods Richards. And his contract is 2 more years, so he only goes up to $3 million. Maybe like throwing like a catch or something like that. Paris is struggling in our AAA. Ed Howard looks like he's finally gonna be ready to go next year. Fuck, Gallegos went down to a B potential. Yeah, he's not really gonna get a chance to play, but like. For some extra depth, I'm here for it. Oh, we'll make this deal work. Yeah, Cassie, we could always bring in another guy. And boom. Yeah, he's about to clear waivers. And Contreras will go down to a double line. So that should be good. And we add a lefty to our rotation. Now what if we add two lefties to our rotation? They're the same overall. There's a 1 year age difference, so yeah, we'll just go with. Who's getting removed from the 40 man? Yeah, we're keeping Rosario more or less for Yeah, I want a Herb England plan. Tim Richards is a natural left fielder, so... Cubs win. Okay, yeah, I want to go to the end of the month. Yeah, this could be a big game, so yeah, we're gonna and the boomer for Gilroy.
John Schaumbe alongside Chris Singleton. We'd like to welcome those just tuning in.
How about any Joey Gallo?
You're right on.
Takes a ball upstairs.
Looking to wrap up a one-run victory in the ninth, but they'll have to navigate through the middle of the order to do it. The next pitch misses. 2-1.
Well, comfortable or not, these are the situations closers they seem to live for. Get into some hot water, a jam, tough spot, whatever you want to call it. But this is where they're
going to keep. Slider.
And it's filled up.
3-2.
And a big run here, and these fans really letting them hear it as well.
Got him!
And a swing and a miss. The tying and go-ahead runs are left.
Big strikeout. Gil Reyes, and he closes it out.
Finish. Tying run at third. The winning run at second base. Somehow, he found a way to make his pitches. Got his team.
And the Cubs end up taking the series. And the Cubs sweep the Brewers.
Inside the show. Inside the
what?
Show. Here's your host.
19-0.
It's Sunday morning. Welcome to.
Yeah, yo, what's happening? What? Matt Chapman.
John Schaumbe alongside Chris Singleton. We'd like to welcome those just tuning in on the show for a live look-in. You're right on time. The Cubbies looking to wrap up a one-run victory in the
ninth. Miss.
But they'll have to navigate through the middle of the order to do it. That one misses in the dirt.
Ball low.
One run game here at the top of the ninth. Next pitch misses.
Pitches inside.
3-2 now.
2-2. The 3-2 pitch. And that ball swung, hit in the air and deep. That ball's up and that ball is gone.
Back there. Into the bleachers and gone.
Matt Chapman goes yard. Go with Ryder. Triple. Are you kidding? Aces juice. Swing and a miss, and the Yankees win 5-3. And the Yankees take the series. Split with the Red Sox.
Allegri.
Great Sunday action lies ahead, but first, here's what happened in the major leagues on Saturday. Looking first at the NL Central, the Chicago Cubs
has
14 hits in the game as they got past the Reds in Cincinnati, 7-3. The Miami Marlins smacked.
That's enough. And we have more.
As they got the best of the Brewers at
home.
And
we have more.
It was their seventh win in a row. Elvis Manuel grabbed win number 6 on the year as the Pirates disposed of the Blue Jays, 5-3. The Cardinals racked up 11 hits as a team as they defeated the visiting fight.
Dislocated it all.
Justin Allegri.
Beginning of the work week and welcome to Inside the Show. In the National
League
Central,
maybe a left-handed arm
dominated
for,
at the dish with 2 long balls and 6 RBIs as the Dodgers defeated the Cubs 12-3. At the start of the day, the Dodgers are leading the National League West, while the Cubs sit in first place.
Okay, yeah, if he's struggling by the deadline, then yeah, we're going to punch
him. Swatted 4 home runs in this one as they took a victory against the Brewers in Milwaukee, 9-6. As of today, the Brewers sit in last place in the National League Central Division, and the Cardinals are second in the division. The Atlanta Braves launched 3 home runs as they defeated the Pirates
looking
at PNC
Park 6-5.
In the standings, the Pirates sit in third place in the National League Central Division, and the Braves are in last place in the NL East. The San Francisco Giants combined for 10 hits as a team.
Guys, who we would look at is
Reds, 6-5. As of right now, the Giants are in second place in the NL West, and the Reds sit in fourth place in the National Central Division.
Even for this for 1 year, I'm not interested.
Grabbed 3 runs driven in, helping the Mets get by the Phillies, 6-5. Entering the day's action, the Mets are in fourth place in the NL East, and the Phillies are atop the division. The Washington Nationals finished off a 3-game sweep as they beat the Giants 4-2. At the start of the day, the Nationals sit in third place in the National League East Division, while the Marlins are second in the division. The Padres allowed only 5 hits as a staff as they took care of the Rocks in Colorado 12-1. As of today, the Rockies are in last place in the NL West, and the Padres are third in the division. The Tampa Bay Rays earned the 3-game series sweep as they took down the Red Sox on the road 4-0. The win was their 5th straight as a team. Heading into the day, the Red Sox
in
the American League East Division, while the Rays are at the bottom of the division. Swung it well with 15 hits in the game as they took down the Yankees in the Bronx 11-6. In the standings, the Yankees are in first place in the American League East, and the Guardians are in first place in the AL Central. The Toronto Blue Jays completed a 3-game series sweep as they got the win in extra innings over the Orioles, 7-6. The win was their 7th in a row. As of right now, the Orioles are leading the American League East,
Brad Martin,
while the Blue Jays are 3rd in the division. Dylan Carlson had a great day driving in 5 on
but
three hits,
I don't know how
leading Detroit to the win over Kansas City, 10-3. As of today, he is the RBI leader in the American League. As of today, the Tigers sit in 2nd place in the AL Central Division, and the Royals are at the bottom of the division. Michael Busch had a big fly with 5 driven in, helping the White Sox dispose of the Twins 5-1. He also extended his hitting streak to a modest 8 straight. Heading into the day, the Twins sit in 3rd place in the American League Central, and the White Sox are 4th in the division. The A's starting pitcher, number 30, got the W and now has
Robert
5
Gill.
This year as Oakland pushed past the Angels 5-4. In the standings, the A's sit in last place in the American League West Division, while the Angels are 2nd in the division. The Seattle Mariners got 11 hits overall as they got the home victory against the Astros 6-1. At the start of the day, the Mariners sit in 4th place in the American League West, and the Astros are 3rd in the division. And that'll do it for today. Enjoy the rest of the All-Star break, and don't forget to tune in over the next couple of days for all the latest.
How are the Twins doing? Twins are in the middle of the wild card race, yeah, so they won't be one league. Why does I think they're struggling? Luis Casey. May not be a bad pickup. Loaiza, he's already. Yeah, but the thing is, I think it was like another lefty. Brady Singer. Oh, wait, oops. Yeah, that's starters. Edwin Diaz. How's our San Francisco doing? Yeah, the Giants would not be willing to give them up either. Left-handed reliever. Suarez is the best. Alvarado, he's noticeable. Sheffield is not pitching bad. But I'm not really sure. He's doing this in Colorado, so that's the good thing. Allen's another noticeable one. So we're looking at Logan Allen, Justin, what was the guy's last name? Last name is so Nationals, Rockies. Rockies are dead last, so yeah, they would be willing to move them. Maybe we can make two moves here. Maybe we can work something out. We're gonna make two. Because PJ Jers is pitching atrocious. He's PJ Jers is pitching awful. He's a risk, but the upside is incredible. mean, yeah, he's done decent. He's done a decent enough job. Nationals. Oh, he's gonna be another one of those guys that goes in a long relief fall, isn't he? Yeah, then no. I think he should get more value back. Okay. Decent of prospects. Jason Gonzalez is 123. Wow. Yeah, McCormick, I'm gonna let go of. He'll be some decent depth, and we'll give you switching pitcher a while. Mark Rosa. Burke's gonna get called up next year. Underwood. That's just some fight to give us back. Gleyber Torres. Yeah, decent enough prospect. Do we want to see Peter Rose? Will we ever use Burns though? That's the thing. Yeah, because some of these guys, yeah, there's no chance we use them. Underwood. Yeah, I don't think we use Vlad Rodriguez. So yeah, let's do this. Are there any prospects that we could potentially poach up? Matt Horn. Okay, I'm not seeing him to the... Maybe there's still some hope for this guy. Maybe he can make a part of this guy's career. Mm-hmm. shit, we got thrown in. Yeah, well. Dylan Cease is in it, and Gil Reyes. Yeah, he's been a pretty consistent closer for us for... Jesus Sanchez, nice. Luis Rodriguez, nice. We should have went in the Grand All-Stars, for fuck's sake. Dominic Solidier. Dominic Smith.
Inside the show.
Victor Robles. Connor Scott. Wow, the trades are flying. Today is the trade deadline.
Here's your host, Justin Allegri.
Well, this is it, the final day of the season for teams to make trades. There could be a flurry of action as the day goes on, but before we get there, here's a recap of what went down yesterday. Starting off in the National League East, the Cardinals put together 10 total hits as they stole a victory in extra innings over the Nationals, 7-4. Trevor Larnach added 3 RBIs to his total, leading the Metropolitans past the Braves, 6-3. The San Francisco Giants pitched well, allowing only 3 hits as they took care of the Rocks in Colorado, 4-0. Alex Vesia
earned
the third W of his season, leading the Dodgers over the Diamondbacks, 4-2. The Angels allowed only 5 hits in the game as they beat the O's in Baltimore, 10-4. The Detroit
Angels
Tigers
doing good.
Combined to give up
Chris
just 5
Hernandez
hits
is doing good.
As they took down the Chi Sox in front of a home crowd, 4-0.
Mount Castle's doing good.
Held the opposition at bay with only 4 hits.
Ian Happ is doing
Guardians, 4-3.
Good. Not what he
did
last year.
Total 11
year,
hits as they secured a win in extra innings over the Padres, 5-4. Ryan Benjamin was a
dude, if he ever
can
start to rest now,
runs,
so.
Leading the A's over the Rays, 5-2. The Blue Jays.
Jesus Sanchez was an All-Star.
As they sank the Mariners,
nice.
17-0. And that's the show. The trade deadline is only hours away, so don't forget to check in tomorrow for a full recap of the
events. Yeah, I'm gonna start to give Fernando Tatis Jr. is on the trade block. Interesting. Okay, but still, the contract's massive. I think, yeah, we're just gonna look at, potentially bring in a few prospects that if they're on the trade block. Yeah, Owen's a guy I'm interested in. Wait, what? He's on the 40 man? Who's on the roster still? So now I'm quite too similar.
Inside the show, here's your host, Justin Allegri.
The trade deadline has come and gone. Here's a recap of what happened on and off the field yesterday. Looking first at the NL Central, the Cincinnati Reds got 12 hits in this one as they nabbed the win against the visiting Cubs 8-4. In other Cubbies news, catcher Matt Owen has been placed on waivers by the club. The Washington Nationals knocked out 10 hits as a team as they got the best of the visiting Redbirds 5-2. The Milwaukee Brewers had 12 hits as a team as they walked off to the extra inning win over the Pirates 5-4. It was their fifth straight victory. The Braves hit three long balls as they took care of the Mets at Citi Field 8-1. Chris McMahon grabbed his fourth victory out of the pen, helping the Marlins take care of the Phillies 3-1. The Giants combined for 10 hits as a team as they took care of the Rocks in Colorado.
I think
Gil
Reyes is a big extension.
The Arizona Diamondbacks pounded out 17 hits in this one as they pushed
yeah,
past the Dodgers at Chavez Ravine 6-5. Nico Horner had a day to remember, amassing an impressive 7 RBIs at the plate, leading the Yanks to a win over the rival Red Sox 14-5.
The Los Angeles Angels Browns off for now.
Their opponent to just 2 hits as they beat the O's in Baltimore 2-1. The Tigers smacked 15 team hits as they got the extra innings win over the White Sox 6-3. The Cleveland Guardians racked up 11 hits as a team as they beat the Royals in Kauffman Stadium 8-4. The San Diego Padres pitched well, allowing only 3 hits as they defeated the Twins in the Twin Cities 4-0. Forrest Whitley won his 4th game thus far as the Rays pushed past the A's 1-0.
5.5.
The Toronto Blue Jays put together 10 total hits as they nabbed the win against the Seattle Mariners 4-3. Akil Baddoo drove in 4, helping the Rangers get past the rival Astros 10-2. And that's the show. Thanks for listening in. I'll be back tomorrow with more news and updates from around the majors.
Inside the show. And now your host, Justin
Owens.
Inside the show. Inside the show. Here's your host, Justin Allegri.
It's Sunday morning. Welcome to Inside the Show. Looking first at the NL Central, the Cubs combined for a 4-hitter as they stomped the Brewers 13-1.
Inside the Show. And now your host. Inside the show with your host, Justin Allegri.
It's the first day of September, the final full month of the regular season, and that, of course, means rosters have been expanded. Major league teams can now carry
as long as we don't choke it.
So we'll be seeing some fresh faces making their debuts in today's games. But before that all gets underway, here's what happened in the final day of August. In the National League Central, the Reds allowed only 5 hits as a staff as they got the win in extras against the Bronx Bombers 1-0. The Brewers knocked out 10 hits as a team.
Inside the show.
91 win.
Inside the show with Justin Allegri.
Hello there, baseball fans. Let's recap what went down around the league on Monday. Looking first at the NL East, the Pittsburgh Pirates totaled 13 hits as a team as they pulverized the Braves 7-1. Entering the day's action, the Braves sit in fourth place in the National League East.
Oh my God, Garcia.
And the Pirates are in third place in the NL Central. They're over 20 games out of first. The Cincinnati Reds combined to allow only...
Inside the... Inside the show. With your... Inside the show. And now your host, Justin Allegri.
The Beginning of the work week, and welcome to Inside the Show. In the National League Central, the Cardinals got 11 hits overall. It's officially scoreboard watching season as the regular season comes to a close here on Inside the Show in the National League.
And we finish with the best record.
Inside the Show. Here's your host, Justin Allegri.
The final postseason.
Yeah, just so we don't lose it, we're going to.
Good evening to those joining us for this live look-in on the show. I'm John Ciambi alongside Chris Singleton. You're just in time. The Cubs up to bat here in the bottom of the inning with a chance to walk it off. Correa in the box now. Take strike one. Next offering is in for a strike.
These home fans, they are making a lot of noise, putting pressure on that pitcher out there.
And he swings and misses. He got him.
Two gone. Wow, just great bite to that slider. Broke hard.
Jonathan India.
He just couldn't hold up the swing. You know, as a hitter, that pitch is really hard to take. And there's just not much you can do with it. You know that.
And there's the third out. That'll do it. Back here at the ballpark.
Come on, Keegan.
71.
And the Jumbo Shrimp win the series, and they're moving on. Are they playing St. Louis or San Francisco? I think I'd rather have India up. India can be our utility infielder. Yeah, he should be ready to go next season. Or, I don't know. Maybe we should give him a roll him right here. League leaders, Mookie Betts, looking bad on average. Brett Beatty. Yeah, let's go check out awards. Pete Alonso wins his third MVP. Juan Rodriguez wins his Owens is Cy Young.
Austin Riley. Anti Mookie Betts and Riley Green. Yeah, Riley Green was a guy that we considered. We considered picking up. As we gotten around the same contract as. Reliever of the year, Dylan Tate. Our boy Alcantara came in third. Annual Class A for the AL. Rookie of the Year. Pete Crow Armstrong came in third. Andrew White. Yeah, I don't think we won any awards this year. Soderstrom came in second for the catching silver slugger. Pete Alonso came in first for first base. Austin Martin came in third. Oh, Julio Rodriguez won one. Yordan Alvarez. How did our team? Robert Hansel did pretty good. Hernandez, pretty good. Julio Rodriguez. Good. Not quite his Seattle days, but I mean. Looks like Mel Kastner is finally starting to regress a little bit. Hap. Still a really good year, and not quite the years he was having in 2027, 2026. Jesus Sanchez did a good job. He's looking to be a pretty good signing for us. Soderstrom, I was doing the catching silver slayer, so he did a really good job. And Austin Martin came in third, so he did a really good job. Bench bats, Clark. Yeah, maybe we should give Clark some more run time next season. India. Meh. Price. Not bad for a backup catcher. Narvaez. Pretty good. How the pitchers do. Dylan Cease, good job. Perez, good. He had the most wins, but I mean, all right. DJ Hall, good job. Wicks, good job. Ryder, not good. Weathers, okay. Suarez, 420. Not what we were looking for. 274 unlock, good. Cody Hoyer, good. He only pitched 27 innings, wow. Casey Lewis, good. Bautista, good for a rookie. Gil Reyes, fantastic. Anyway, yeah, that'll do it for this episode. Hope you all enjoyed. Have a good one, and I'm out. Bye.